Yo guys, I'm Tooru and welcome to a this is sort of tutorial for an achievement that you can do in the game. This is going to be the I can't remember what it's called, Freegypt. So the achievement's called Freegypt, which is where as Egypt you become a free nation. So you have to start as the United Kingdom and you have to, using the autonomy system, you have to become free. Oh my goodness, sorry for things are double clicking my mouse. I need to get a new mouse. It's freaking, it's not going very well. Alright, so first tip to this, you want to keep the United Kingdom as strong as possible. So you're going to go on historical focuses. That way that you're going to, that way they're as strong as possible and they can defend you since you're right next to Italy. Because you want to be producing as much as possible and not capitulate. Now the thing is, I when I make these videos, I like to ask myself, what can I do to optimize something as much as possible? And with this, I was thinking, how can I do this as quickly as possible? What was the quickest way to become free is Egypt? And I don't mind the anime mod, this is something I have on because I can still do achievements with it on, and it's a little nice thing to look at, I guess. So now you might be wondering, what is the quickest way to become free is Egypt? The quickest way to do that is actually, we're going to be going full naval. So we're not going to be participating in the war, we're not going to have any army, we're not going to have an air force. We're not even going to have ships, we're going to have convoys. Because convoys, we're going to be building like crazy. Convoys are the one thing that have the highest trade autonomy from what I've found. There might be something better, but it probably costs a lot more to produce than convoys do. In which you could just get 3 naval dockyards right off the bat, you could start producing them 70 days after starting the game. And then doing a few exploits and using little modifiers like free trade, partial mobilization, stuff like that. You can construct them faster, you can have more dockyard output, and then you can produce more convoys. So this is just going to be more of a step-by-step process for me, like of me showing how to do it as quickly as possible. I learned from my previous tutorials that like I want them to be within the course of maybe 5-10 minutes. I don't want them to be too long. Nothing that will take too much of your time. Looking at stuff like what Feedback does, it's actually pretty nice seeing him doing Let's Plays and stuff. I don't think I could do that. I can't. I'm not a talkative person. I can't just talk. Okay, so first getting your dockyards, you want to go completely into convoy. Don't worry about the iron, because it doesn't really matter right now. You're just wanting to get as many convoys out as possible, and you want to build these dockyards as quickly as possible. So taking away the civilian, because these civilian, so these, if you trade even one, the other one will go to your consumer goods. You don't want to do that. So you won't be constructing any, so you'll go from 2 to 0. So you don't want to be trading. Go to construction. I'm not actually going to stick onto this. I'm actually going to be using an exploit that allows me, well, you'll see what it is in a second. And I'll be showing how to do it. So once you get 100 political power, you're wanting to do both anti-raids. You're staying, okay. So I've done this before. So this is actually, I had to do this achievement twice. Because when I did it the first time, I went fascist because I did want to get the autonomy from participating in the war as Egypt. You don't have much manpower. So I went fascist and took advantage of the manpower increases. It gets you 5 recruitable population and then 2 recruitable population. But going fascist changes the type of puppet you are, and that just fucks up the achievement. And by the time I hit 1956, which was when I didn't really know any optimizations for it, and I became free, it didn't count it because I didn't go through all the specific steps it required, because it changed my autonomy type. Okay, so now we're going to do the exploit. You want to be doing both of these at the same time. If this is patched in the future, that's fine. Just go for concentrated. They both give you the same amount, but I would go for concentrated just because you can build more you build more naval dockyards through the concentrated. So, going this, you want to do research, keep this open, go to the next one, click that, you're both in. You're researching both. You could do this with pretty much anything that gives you multiple options. Anything that gives you, that you're only allowed to research one, you can do this, and if you have five, you can research, like, all the doctrines at once. So doing this, you can, it's really, really stupid, and they're probably gonna patch it in the future, which I hope they do. This is actually kind of OP, but, okay, so now we got political power. We're gonna go for industry, and you're, okay, so with this, you're gonna only want to focus on these, all the way up to the research slot, but you're gonna go here, here, and then research slot. Because the research slot right now isn't very strong. And for this, we're going to be going to free trade. Don't use partial move. As I explained before, you don't have, you only have two civilian factories, so it won't give you any more doing that. And partial mobilization doesn't give you any construction speed for, so like they don't give you any boost for building dockyards. So it's kind of pointless to go for it right now. Just wait till you have more from the industrial focuses, and it's kind of stupid how it won't let me open it, but you get what I mean. So we're just going to sit on convoys until we're in the war, because convoys, I think they give you 3 points some odd autonomy, and I'll be showing that later. So trading like 300 of these will give you 1,000, enough to get up a whole thing in one go. So you're like trading 150 or something like that, you can get to the next autonomy, then trading 300, get the next one, and then 300, get the next one. And then bang, you're done. You could also go for promises of peace, since we're not really going for war, war economy. And this does give you more, because increasing your stability does, and this is why I'm doing this, increasing your stability will give you more dockyard output, so I think I actually am gonna do it, just because it, like, the more stability you have, the more you produce, which means the more convoys you produce. And since we're not focusing on building any sort of army whatsoever, we don't need these, we don't need this, don't need that. We're just focused on industry. And no army ones. It's kind of pointless to trade guns to them, because it gives you hardly any autonomy doing that. With improved workers' conditions, I'm pretty sure it doesn't affect your... It does not. It doesn't affect your convoy production, so go for this as much as you can. I couldn't remember if it did or not, it doesn't. So going for that to increase your stability is actually a viable option, because it doesn't decrease the amount of convoys you're producing. For your industry and your construction, focus on these, because you won't need oil, you won't need the production, because this doesn't affect your convoy production. These are the ones that affect your convoy production. This one affects your dockyard construction. So just focus on those and you'll do just fine. And by the time you get into the war, you should have a very sizable amount of convoys. Because, I mean, it's only just now getting 1937, I've doubled the convoys I started with. Okay, once you get 100 political power, you're going to want to get the war industrialists, just because they're going to increase your dockyard constructions. So when you get the next political power after getting all these, just go for industrial concern, just because it'll give you construction boosts to all these. Well, except this, it won't give you that, but you can get them for these, and they'll make things a lot easier. As we near the end of 1937, as I showed when 1936 ended, I had 60 convoys, and I almost have double what I started with in 1937, so this is quadrupled since I started now. So this is a pretty good demonstration of how this is actually working. So I guess the best thing you could do now is maybe go for Liberty Ethos to get an extra focus out of the way, because we're going to be going for another focus soon that will help. I'm just going for these ahead of time, just because, I mean, there's nothing really else to research besides your industry, so may as well just go for them ahead of time. So we got the naval production and all this political power we're going to sit on, we're not going to spend it. And at this point, if you really wanted to, you could get more steel. So, and don't trade from the United Kingdom, because it will lower your autonomy if you do that. Trade with France. You might be thinking, oh, why trade? I mean, you could also trade. I actually don't. No, don't trade with France. Trade with the Soviets, because the Soviets France will mostly capitulate, so trading with the Soviets is a much better option because you're not wasting your a boost, an extra civilian factory on France, because it will be wasted on them, and get rid of that because we don't need it right now. At this point, use like when you're not really trading yet, I would recommend using your political power, like when you have it, to get to 100% stability. And then once you're at that, then sitting on it. But I should have said that earlier. I didn't really think about it. But yeah, that's something that you should do. So if we were on Dominion right now, we would be able to become free because we have 300 political power. So the most you need is 450. So as long as you're above 450, you can just spend away, I guess. So once you get the 450, just set that 450 as your zero margin. And then 150 after that, you can spend the stuff. But so like, if you get to 600, then once you're at 600, you can buy the, not buy it, but like use your political power to get like partial mob or war economy, so you can start building civs and stuff like that. Makes it just something you can do. Oh, sure. All right. So while I wait for the war to start, so I can. Because when the war starts, I can start talking about which, like trading convoys and stuff like that, but and how I figured that out. But last week I was supposed to upload two videos. One, I was supposed to start a new series on Nier Automata, and then Friday I wanted to make a video about me attempting. I'm calling it Patchouli's Basics, but it's like happy stealing with Marisame Kirisama, or I can't remember her name. I don't know Toho, so I apologize for that. But I wanted to make those videos, but recently our house has been a little loud, just because one, my brother has since my brother moved out last year, we've been trying to make up the room because my mom wants to move some of the kids downstairs next to my room, which is gonna be fucking awful, I think, because they'll be so loud. But I'll have to figure something out there. But well, I'll see how it is first about that. But what we've been doing Wednesday was painting the room next to mine. So it was painting the room, moving things around the whole time, and I didn't want to stream. I didn't want to record during that because that wasn't great. It was loud. And then after that, on Friday was the start of the house, because our neighbor had the idea, we agreed to it. It was a good idea, and we went through with it. We decided to repaint the exterior of the house, and so this took a while, and that meant I was helping out with that. Then it didn't help that Friday I woke up really late, and I really didn't have time to record that day either. But at that point, it was like I couldn't record if I wanted to that day, because it was just one, it was too late, and two, it was too loud and I was busy. And then Saturday, I didn't stream on Sunday. I streamed on Saturday because I saw a window, because they were only painting on Saturday. And then Sunday, my neighbor was soldering stuff or something next door, and my room is directly adjacent, well, opposite to their workshop, and that's so yeah, it's not that great whenever they're doing that and I'm trying to record or stream or something, because I like when I'm doing anything, it's just the whole time, like them sawing or sanding, whatever they're doing down there. And that wasn't viable for me to really stream that day. So I apologize for not getting anything out, but I couldn't really do anything about that. Now when I did this before, when I actually did the achievement, I had a bad run, and they managed to capitulate me, so it took a lot longer. But as long as I trade these convoys in quickly, it should be okay. So I want about 300 more convoys than what I got. That should be the optimal amount. So what is that? 7 times 2 is 14. And then 4 times 3. 4 times 3 is 12. So that's 20. That's 26 with division. It's an interesting template. There you go. Battle Bishop calls in. We're going to start our lend lease. Okay, so as you can see, this gives a huge amount of autonomy for one convoy. Don't do the monthly or this. Like, look at that. 1% of the production, that's disgustingly low. Monthly deals the same amount. You can pretty much do that if you want, but I'm not going to do it. I think a more controlled one, because I could just get all of it all at once, and I don't have to rely on giving away a specific amount each time. But, so let's see. We need 500. And also, I would recommend doing attaches, just because that gives you extra autonomy. So, 500. So 500 divided by 3.5. Let's get our trusty calculator out here on my phone. 500 divided by 3.5. 142. But it says 0.8, so I'm gonna do 143. There you go. Yep. All right. So that's 500 autonomy instantly. Well, the ones this is sent, it's 500 instantly. And the reason I'm giving attaches is just because so the British do a lot better in Africa, and they might hold France a bit better. Actually, they're not even in France, are they? No, they're not in France. And Republic of Spain is stomping on national Spain. They might actually win the Civil War before. Oh my goodness, they're actually holding. What was that accent I just did? Holding. They're holding. You also get some army experience too, which is nice. It does suck that our stability is lower just because we're at war, but I mean, it doesn't really matter. If you really want to boost the Soviets, you could do, you can't really request license production because they won't accept it, but just buying their stuff, just like buying excess stuff like that, like buying their resources, that's a good idea if you're wanting to just boost them. And Republic of Spain will be joining the Allies today, apparently, I think. Is that correct? No. National Spain can't call them in because it's not... Right, it has to be 50% for them to be able to call them in. And if I can remember... So, let's see. 28... Next delivery is 28 days. Okay, so we're at 98. Not sure why I did that. Let's just switch over to this one. Just to get that little bit left. Bank for a colony. Now to get to a dominion, we need 1,000. All right, so to get 1,000, modify lend lease, let's cancel this. Let's cancel it. Then start it again. So 1,000, how many do we have to do? I think it was 291 or 92 in order to do it. 500 divided by, no, not 500, 1,000 divided by 3.5, 285. It's actually a lot lower than I thought it was. So let's see, 285. So I'm just going to do 290, actually, just get a little above, because for whatever reason, it was actually below when I did it before. All right, so now when we get this through, it gives us 1,000 autonomy in 1 month. Beats doing the stupid, working with an army and trying to get war score. I tried doing the war score route. I ended up just doing the convoys just because it was quicker. I even built bombers to bomb Italy, but that gave me practically nothing. if this doesn't show how overpowered it is to become like convoys are to get autonomy, I don't know what would, because like I don't think anything else in the game really gives you as much autonomy. And look at all these bonuses we get. Our construction is going to be done too soon. No. I could send an attaché to them as well, but I'm not gonna, just because I don't want to lower my political power too much. Wait till I'm at like 500 in order to do it. The reason I would do it, I think it'd be wasted in France, but it would give me tons of military XP because they're fighting Italy. I mean, UK is fighting Italy too, but not with as much divisions, and they're not holding. Okay. And we're Dominion. Oh, it only costs 50. Okay, so maybe I was wrong about that one. Alright, so now we need 1,000 more. So I don't have enough yet. So we're just gonna sit on. We're gonna sit on this. On our convoys just a little bit. Okay, so to get us. How many we needed? We need 209. I'm gonna build 290. So let's see, that is 100, so it's 253. Hold it. Nope, there, and bang, 137. So once we have 137 more convoys, that'll be 290, we could send them, and we should be able to come free. And actually, if I'm correct, we should be able to become free before the... let's see, how many we're building per day? It's kind of hard to tell, but because it doesn't really give you. We could produce 5.68 units. Okay, so I'm just gonna let this run. 5.68 units. 5.68 times 137 convoys that we're making. So that's per week divided by 7. Take 111 days to build all the convoys. So, okay, hold on. It's December 3rd. Actually, I'm not gonna about it. It's like 100 something. It's like, we'll be done by March. We will be free by March. Honestly, if you're ever playing Egypt just for fun, I recommend just go to free trade. The oil, like the amount of resources you produce, it doesn't even matter. Like, you don't produce enough resources to really have it really matter. There's no penalty for doing it. Okay. With these, we'll be able to... Well, now we have even more benefits. So now it should actually take even less time to get it. So I think... Yeah, February, March. Yeah, we should be done by March. And especially with another dockyard helping us. That make things a lot easier. The only thing I really see anyone playing Egypt for is for the achievement. Like, doing this in an actual multiplayer game, it'd feel like you're throwing. Or, either you're throwing, or you're trying to set up an air-controlled zone in the Mediterranean. Because if you take this out for Egypt, and then give them, well, allow them to take this, and then take you can release the nations here, let them take that, take Saudi Arabia, Yemen, and then release these nations, let them take that, and then they'll be able to, they'll get cores on all this, they'll be really powerful, and then they'll be able to help you take out Italy. That's the only practical use I could think of. Alright, so we got two more. That should be all the convoys we ever have to produce. It is April. Okay, so a little later than I thought it was going to be. It's still 290. It's 1,015. So by May 17th, we will be a free nation. And we're free. Bang. May 19th, 1940, we are a free nation. And the only thing we ever did was build convoys. That's my little tutorial on how to get Freegypt the easiest way possible and the quickest way possible. There might be a quicker way, but this is the quickest way I found. So thanks for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed. Maybe you found this useful. And I will see you guys next time for whatever video I'm making next.